about to poke out. A kid got choked out, bones was thrown, and a fucking fight broke out. Come on, motherfucker. Can't we just all get along so I can put pinkies on a chest like little Sean?
Carlstadt on our East Coast headquarters. I got involved into strength training through a gym called Strong Shapeling, very well-known gym on the East Coast. I met Tommy, I met Mike, a couple other people that brought me into strongman. Before that, I just bodybuilded from the ages of 14 till about 18 when I met them. Started competing in strongman in 2013. I think that was my first competition. Then ever since, I've been competing consistently, a couple competitions a year. I've owned the gym for maybe 6 months now. Other half is Cameron Gardner. He's not here right now, he's on vacation. Our initial plan was, when I took over the gym, it was a CrossFit gym. I kept the classes very similar. Made the programming and the training much more logical than your traditional CrossFit training. And, you know, we have all the strongman equipment because that's my main source of training and getting stronger, and that's what we live by and what we believe in. You know, strongman for life. But it wound up turning into a powerlifting gym. Now you have all these guys down here that are competing in powerlifting, probably put a powerlifting team together. And, right from there, already some of them are interested in strongman and want to compete in strongman.
Tom Yanuzzi, 27 years old, from Belleville, New Jersey. I've been doing strongman since I did my first competition when I was in high school, 2002, 2004-ish, as a teen. Then I went to college, got out of college, started doing training again in 2009. I've been training under Cameron Gardner and Scott Brangle. They're the founders of East Coast, West Coast. I'm a strength coach at Crank Systems in Nutley and also at East Coast, West Coast in Carlstadt, New Jersey. Strongman grew very fast in the last couple of years from just fitness in general getting bigger. Strongman has gotten bigger. When we used to do shows, probably 5 years ago, there was one or two shows around. Now you can find one every weekend within 2-3 hours away. So this sport definitely grew very fast, and it has to do, I think, with fitness growing, healthy lifestyles. It's not taboo to train anymore. Even in sports where people really didn't train for sports, now you have to train to get a scholarship, go to college, get better. So definitely grew fast when fitness got bigger or more popular. And also I think CrossFit did somewhat help strongman, putting it in the games and stuff. So that kind of helped.
years old. I've been competing in strongman since summer of 2000. We started in May of 2007, so it's been about almost 9 years now. When I first started competing in strongman, it felt like nobody really knew about it. So this was 2007. It was still very kind of like foreign to some people. Now, with the help of social media, it definitely seems like it's the community itself has it, with the forums and the Instagram posting and all the Facebook posting. It definitely has brought a lot of people together. And I think, like Frankie said earlier, you know, I've been to powerlifting meets and weightlifting meets as well, and you don't feel like, you know, you got in strongman when you're at a competition, there's people that you barely even know. You have no idea who they are, but you see them carrying a sandbag and you just start rooting for them because you know they're in the same boat that you are and they're going through the same pain that you're going through. So to me, I think the community is much more closer in strongman than it is in any other strength sport. So, but the, as a whole, it definitely has grown since all the social media and stuff. It's definitely way more out there now in the open. You know, I'm usually here on Saturdays, so when I come in, it's definitely pumping. The music is blasting. You got the guys in the back training hard. Once we start rocking and rolling, it's kind of cool for some of the new guys to see when we start going and start training. You'll see a lot of times like everyone kind of stop what they're doing and start watching us what we're doing and asking questions and rooting everybody on. So I mean, this gym as a whole in the last 6 months has definitely built up a presence of we're here to work and everyone here is just trying to get better and everyone's here trying to help each other and it's pretty cool to see the different, you know, aspects of all the people coming in and trying to do what they're trying to do, like Frankie said, all trying to hit their numbers and everyone's just trying to get better, which is awesome. It's a friendly atmosphere and they're coming in to work, so definitely been cool.
Put that on my hood, I bet I do them dirty. From A block to town, man, you already know how you rock. Bet he think again before he come back to New Jersey. Ha ha, let's go.
Consistent with your training, find a competition, don't be scared of a competition, find one, train for it, do it, who cares if you zero, just go out there, have fun, try and do better than what you did in training or from your last competition, find a good group of guys or a crew to train with, and train every Saturday, I don't know. But yeah, thank you.